Cat and mouse upgrade points 10. Here we go. Alright, let's see here. Oh, gotta get that. There's some flies buzzing around the TV. Oh, I hate those little things.
Ugh.
They're like little.
I hate fly season.
Yeah, they're like. They're attracted to the light. Oh. Let's see here.
Yeah. It's all mosquito haven here.
Oh, yeah. Ooh. Yeah, we're gonna be seeing a lot of that too over the summer. It's nuts, man. Big news. Unfortunately, negotiations broke down with Adrian Buck, but I'm happy to report I'll be following Chase the Rib as the subject of my next documentary, which is very cool because I was such a huge Ribby fan. Hope you like your ribs extra spicy, America. Flame, flame, flame. Wow.
My God.
Oof. Just noticed if you like your post about the tournament win, maybe a sign. Who knows? But I'm not interested in going back. I have all the moments in the world. I'm going to keep it going. Let's see. Nothing. Okay. After outlasting 29 other superstars, Slade WWE is your Royal Rumble winner. Nothing can stop me from achieving greatness. The WWE Championship awaits. That's cool and all, but have you tried winning the Apex tournament like Aerodynamic? Blocked. Just fucking blocked on Twitter. It's like, fuck
well,
you.
Well, shice.
Yeah. Fucking hell. Oh, this mode is a lot more fun than 2K22's, I think. And Justine, what's this one?
Well, that happened. My game crashed out of nowhere.
Oof.
Congratulations! So how does it feel to be the hottest thing in pro wrestling since Paul Heyman's undershirt?
Yeah, it's been doing that every so often. Like, and it's completely random. Like the game will just
First,
encounter a random error and then just crash.
Second, I'm going to need a minute while I erase that image from my brain.
Yeah, it happens. Red Dead used to be like that.
Heyman's words, not mine. So, any chance you'd like to come on?
I'll tell you
show?
One thing.
Talk
There's one game that I'm actually really
WWE?
Excited to play since I've already beaten the Spider-Man once. I'm really excited for Miles
Don't
Morales Spider-Man.
I'm a huge fan of
nice.
Tavish and I listen whenever we can. I'm just not sure.
Miles Morales is easily one of the cooler Spider-Man characters ever made.
Oh, come on. Your run in the Apex tournament was incredible. And that's exactly what my listeners want to hear about.
Still, not as cool as original Spider-Man, but definitely up there.
No time like the present, I guess.
Oh, my guy's going to be in a podcast. Let's fucking go. All right.
Ooh, nice.
Great. Let's set up a time ASAP.
Podcast.
There we go. Let's see where this story goes. Oof.
And just hearing podcasts got me thinking of the South Park episode. You have zero friends when Cartman started his own Facebook podcast.
Hey,
and I love Stan's reaction to seeing it for the first
podcast.
Time.
Loud and clear. talking in code again about a platter of stale ribs you threw in the trash. Clearly up to your own tricks.
Chase, I was not the one that eliminated you. You lost to fucking El Ordinario, and I fucking threw the guy who threw you out. Like, just when the guy was, the guy only had like 2 seconds to breathe before I threw him out. So I didn't eliminate you. That was on you, dude. You fucking fucked up.
I have to be totally honest. I have no idea who you are.
There's something funny about my wrestler saying that, considering, like, I literally have him on a 2K22 My Rise mode where I've played with him. Like, my wrestler should know who he is. That's the funny part. It's like Chase keeps meeting alternate universes of me, like alternate wrestlers named Aerodynamic. It's like, last year I met you, Chase. We were tag team partners once, remember? Oh no, that was a different universe.
Name's Chase. Had a stint at
the PC. I'm just getting Spider-Verse vibes.
Or you might even know me as Ribby. Ring any bells?
Ribby, ring any bells?
Oh, for sure. You're that mascot guy who almost made it to WWE. How'd that all play out?
Oh, don't play dumb with me.
He sounds different.
Exactly how we played out. I never got a contract offer because you told Shawn Michaels to stay away from the ribs in catering, which was clearly code to avoid me.
Wow. Listen, I'd love to stay and clear this nonsense up, but Cole Quinn called into my podcast appearance to talk smack, and now I've got to go give him a receipt.
Oh, I know. I was listening. I like the part when he said you haven't changed one bit since your mocap meltdown.
Oh yeah, that's also part of the story. My guy has a fucking freak out at the mocap session. There's a bit where, is it, I don't think you'll give a shit about spoilers, do you? Like, do you care about spoilers?
Nah.
Okay, depending on the path you take, you'll get to one thing where you'll have like a meltdown in the WWE, and it's just 3 months later. And after that point, it reveals that you're doing like the mocap sessions at the 2K like studio for the wrestling moves, and you have to fight Cole Quinn, who's also like a universal constant. He's like in all the other prior games. Fucking like at a certain point, your guy will be confronted with Sami Zayn, one of the wrestlers in the game, who fucking mocks you for how you fucked up your opportunity to be in the company, WWE, and you lose your shit and actually threaten to hit him with the fucking Money in the Bank briefcase until they have to escort you out of there by security. Some shit like that.
God.
We'll see about that. Good luck, Chase. I hope you get to the bottom of whatever deranged conspiracy theories you were talking about.
Oh, I doubt that very much.
Oh man, there's one game that I kind of wish we could play together, just because. But I don't know if it's still free on PlayStation Network.
Let's see.
Borderlands: The Handsome Collection.
Hold on. Voices Commission is the most number of characters you've ever had. Matt was asking me, is this the most characters you've ever had in a commission? And I'm like, not really. I've had one where I've done 10 characters, but While I did like the commission, because it was for my friend Poiter, I think, it was like a Skies of Arcadia reference. I don't think I could do 10 characters anymore. I gotta keep it down to at least 4 or 5 at the most. It's like, I just can't. At a certain point, you start to get very tired of drawing so many characters.
Yeah. I mean, it's kind of the same thing with animating.
Let me see here. Checking my notes too. Oh, someone named Kate360 added me recently on the Furfinity. Or something like that. It's like somebody draws like sneeze kink art. They seem like a nice person though. Their artwork is really, really good.
Yeah, I'm gonna look into that actually. Let me see if I can. Oh yeah, Kate360. Yeah, I've been a watcher of theirs for a while. Some really cute art.
Yeah, like they have a nice elephant character that I really like.
Yeah, so, she is adorable.
Yeah. Elephants are probably the best characters to make when it comes to like the sneeze kink and shit. It's like,
of course they are.
Like elephants.
They've been that way
werewolves.
Ever since cartoons.
Yeah, like elephants, dragons, werewolves. That's the good shit right there.
Bears.
Bears is good too.
Mm-hmm.
The best kind of characters are usually like the big ones.
Yeah. That Papa Heffalump.
Oh god, that one comic I drew. I should have gone all the way and just. I might do a part two sometime.
Hey, if you do, I look forward to it.
Nice try, Chase. Chase was actually gonna hit me with a fucking chair. I was able to stop him.
You know, it's funny. In Spider-Man, the mechanics kind of function a bit like a. I guess I could say it's kind of like a cross between like a Spider-Man combat and pro wrestling, because there are some characters that you actually need to like incorporate different attacks to actually get them down.
Right.
I mean, like Wilson Fisk, aka the Kingpin, was one such character because of the fact that he's like a big fucking dude.
It's not about winning. It's not about the money, Spider-Man. It's about the Mets. Let's go Mets! Come on, it's all about the Mets. Hit me a home run, baby. that's one of my favorite memes. It's not about the money, Spider-Man. It's about the Mets. Hit a home run, baby. It's about the Mets. Let's go Mets.
There's one sequence of the game that I actually that I actually got to, Batman Arkham Asylum flashbacks to. It's the first mission you encounter. It's the first mission in which you encounter Scorpion.
Ooh.
See, you don't get to fight Scorpion right away. In the level where he makes his first appearance, he stabs Spider-Man with his stinger, and it turns out that the stinger was coated with a hallucinogenic neurotoxin. So Spider-Man is basically trying to fight his now damaged brain as he tries to find an antidote.
I think one of my favorite characters, at least when I first, I'm sure it changes at the end of it, but my favorite one was the relationship between him and Doc Ock in that game.
Oh yeah. Yeah. Cause that's actually one of the more heartbreaking villain stories because Octavius, he's just trying to save his body because of the fact that he has a neurologic disease that's making him lose control over the rest of his body.
Yeah.
Yeah, so at the same, while you want to help him so that he doesn't have to stay completely
Shit, I accidentally hit the referee.
Oh dear.
I collided into the wrong person. Whoopsie daisy.
Whoops.
I noticed that it's a lot easier now to collide into the referee without thinking about it. That makes it actually even funnier now.
But yeah, the whole relationship you have with Dr. Octavius, it's more heartbreaking because you don't want him to end up being quadriplegic.
Oh wow. That's gotta hurt, being quadriplegic. That sucks.
Ooh. Yeah. I mean, at the same time, you want there to be a solution where he can actually keep the arms, but doesn't end up becoming the villain.
Yeah.
I gotta say, though, I do love the addition of Mr. Negative.
I remember that character. It was kind of creepy, not gonna lie, when I first, got introduced to him. He's the one that's, in the photo negative, right?
Yeah, Mr. Negative is one of the creepier villains. I do love it when Peter Parker encounters a clue that basically hints that's what he's gonna end up fighting. he sees a negative photo of Martin Lee and his wife. Or, no, not his wife, his parents, and he's like, creepy.
Good old Chase. See what his...
You could just blow me off, huh?
Not so fast.
It's not polite to show up.
But yeah, going back to the the mission with Scorpion. things just get really messed up in that because once you're poisoned, Spider-Man begins hallucinating that New York is being submerged in a massive sea of poison while he tries to find the antidote. And then the closer you get to finding the antidote, giant scorpion tails will start shooting out of the sea and then try to sting you while you're swinging in midair.
Oh wow.
You sure you don't want to catch your breath first? I'm not interested in...
It gets crazy.
Nope. You'll actually be doing me a favor. Two wins and one night is exactly the kind of buzz I need right now.
Oh shit, I'm gonna fight Chase right after fighting Cole Quinn.
Very confident for a WWE washout. Okay, tough guy. If you've got so much gas left in the tank, why don't we make it a no DQ match?
He sounds like fucking Ellis from Left 4 Dead. this one time, I fought Aerodynamic in a no DQ match. It was fun.
Did I ever tell you the time that army bombed my buddy Keith? Kind of makes you want to know Keith.
Yeah, we need fucking Keith in, like, as a playable character if they ever make Left 4 Dead 3. Just make Keith a playable character. Or is he dead? Like, is he canonically dead or alive in the story? I don't know.
I think he's canonically dead.
Oh. Let's see.
Oh, man.
Oh, here's a fun fact. Roger Bumpus actually did the Squidward voice as a major character in Carmen Sandiego before SpongeBob was a thing.
Nice.
Yeah, he played the chief in Where in the World is Carmen Sandiego, and I remember. Yeah, he basically did the SpongeBob voice for that character.
Oh man, you want to know a character that I think would be. You want to know a character that I think would be perfect to add to WWE? Alex Mercer from Prototype.
Yeah, maybe. I've never played that game. I've heard of it. Yeah, it could work.
I'll just recite his opening quote. My name is Alex Mercer. I'm the reason for all of this. They call me a killer, a monster, a terrorist. I'm all of these things.
When it comes to wrestling games, I still think we need the best,
like,
of
them. Actually realistic.
Like, we need, like, the real, we need, like, video game wrestlers, all the characters from Namco, Capcom, SNK. We need, like, something like that.
Hey, add the assassins from Assassin's Creed.
Are they wrestlers too?
Well, they mainly do close quarters combat, and when they actually get into close quarters fights, they'll often use fists or weapons. So. See what other characters to recreate.
If you want, I can share play the community creations. Have I showed you?
No, I'm good.
I've showed you the wrestlers I've made so far, right? I forget.
Yeah.
Patrick, Vinny, Funday, Miranda, Beverly.
Yep.
Yeah, Vinny looks better with the jackets they got in 2K23.
Mm-hmm. Oh man, one dude to implement should be like the dude from the Walking Dead video game.
Negan? A Negan?
No, not her. The main guy.
For some reason I was thinking that dude with the baseball bat. It'd be funny though. He's in Tekken 7 and I fucking love that. You okay there, bud?
Yeah.
Dude, fucking, if we ever knew how to make fucking Tekken 7 mods, imagine making us in the game.
Oh man, that would be awesome. Ooh, do you want to know a game that I think would actually be kind of fun to share play? Trials of Mana.
Maybe. That's the RPG or something, right?
Yeah. One thing I love about the game is that choosing the characters changes the story, more or less.
Shit, he's actually got me. There we go. Sorry, Chase, it's for your own good.
All right, dude. I'm gonna bail now. I got a shower, and I'm probably gonna get ready for bed since I got work in the morning.
Fair enough. I'm probably gonna take a break myself. I might lay down, just because I've been on this chair all day. I'm pretty tired.
No, I gotcha.
It was good to hang out with you, though, man. Oh, it's been a while.
Oh, hell yeah. Yeah, and I'll definitely hop onto 2K23 when I've got the time.
Hell yeah. Now that the Wi-Fi's working better, you, me, and Cryptic can play.
Oh, hell yeah.
Yeah, it's been a dog's age. We got a jam in this game.
Alright. Yeah, okay. and let's not forget, we should try to schedule a use your words so that the entire group can join in, either as players or spectators.
Yeah, totally.
Yeah, and we actually should get some spectators because, believe it or not, there are some achievements that we could get just by having the spectators react to some of our responses.
Hey, you know, like, if we can pull that off, we'll be able to do that, like, on Twitch or something. That's where the audience will come in. Or maybe we could do, like, a YouTube stream or something, maybe.
Yeah, a YouTube stream would be cool. The only problem is that we'd likely have to do it from mine because I've got the game and it's and it would be kind of tricky to do it otherwise.
Right.
The only issue, at least in my particular regard, is I do not know how a YouTube stream works.
Okay.
Yeah, so I might need to ask for some tips.
We'll figure out, because I don't know. I don't know either, to be honest. Like,
yeah, we'll figure something out.
Yeah.
All right. I'm gonna head out. I'll message you on Discord later.
All right. I'll be in touch with you. Take care, man.
Yeah. See ya.
See ya. Bye. Can do a little bit more. Wow, Corey Klein's an asshole. Jeez. Fucking wow. Alright, let's save this here. I'm probably gonna go get something to eat. Alright. I don't know if I want to do like a story mode thing right now. Okay, let's save it here. Actually, you know what? Before I head off, I do want to clip one more video. And this is, now when I say, because this video is going to go up a little bit early, I'm just going to consider it a, bit of an update. So, right after I dropped that community creations thing that I made, it's been kind of difficult to really work on the wrestlers right now. Just got a lot going on in my life. So I'm going to just kind of say, hey, I'm going to throw something in the CC just to kind of keep you guys occupied, at least for me and my friends. I've been really slow in working all these wrestlers. I think it was a big mistake to tackle all of them at once, because now I got to do all the moves. So, yeah. So, anyway, I'm going to do this, like, right now. Let me at least, just to get it out of the way. Community creations. Let me see here. Actually, while I'm here, is there anything I missed from that my friends made? Anything new? Hey, not bad. That's Rocky's versions of the Steels. Solid. Alright. Here we go. So. Oh, this is downloads. Whoops. Okay. Let me see what I have. Superstar moves into championships. Alright. Hashtag list, YouTube, GNC, I mean, I guess DeviantArt, but a series. All right. Well, that is the new one, so. Alright, let's get this one out of the way. This should be the current one. Oops. Got that out of the way. All right, clip, record, that goes up on YouTube. There we go. Uno, dos, tres, let's go. All right, cool. Let's clip of that.